Well, I'm here with Shane Anderson, who is a bullfighter here at the Big Four Rodeo, the Canoe Mountain Rodeo here in Valemount. Shane, welcome to Valemount.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here.
So let me ask you, how long have you been a bullfighter?
I've been a bullfighter for about 2 years so far. I'm still pretty new to it.
Okay, how'd you get into it?
I actually rode bulls for about 6 years, and when I started riding bulls, got a little bored with it, wasn't having as much fun anymore, and decided I want to start fighting bulls because I still want to be part of rodeo, and it's about the only thing I knew in rodeo, so.
So you get tossed from bulls a lot as a rider, but you get tossed in the air a lot as a bullfighter too.
Yeah, you do. You get tossed quite a bit, but you know, I'm also a firefighter on my day job, so I look at it a lot like being a firefighter and get in there, get out, and you know, help the cowboys out and make sure they can get to the next rodeo and do their job.
So let's back up a little bit and talk about, so people think bullfighter, if they don't know rodeo, they're thinking about, you know, the old Spanish guys with the swords and the capes and stuff. Bullfighter in rodeo is exactly what's your job?
My job is to get in between the bull and make myself look like an easier target than the bull rider to make sure he can get up and get back to the chutes to where he's safe, and it gives me the opportunity to be quick on my feet and move around and, like I say, make them bulls look like I'm the easier target and make it a little bit easier on the cowboys.
So you've been doing it for 2 years now. What kind of injuries have you had?
Bullfighting, I've done is gotten a couple bruised legs and stuff like that. I've been pretty fortunate so far. We haven't had to take a lot of hits. But riding bulls, I broke my legs, my arms, my fingers. I've broken almost every bone in my body so far. So
this is actually a healthier occupation.
Yeah, so far. And the nice thing with bullfighting is your career longevity is a lot longer. You know, a bull rider... When you ride bulls, you go to about 30, and that's kind of the breaking point because you just don't heal the same anymore. As a bullfighter, you learn technique and you learn how to work animals, and the more and more you work them, the longer and longer you can stay in it. You know, there's guys like Lloyd Ketchum that's 60 years old, and he can still go out and fight a pen of bulls.
Wow, that's amazing. So yesterday here, Saturday at the rodeo, you guys were busy.
Yeah, we were very busy. We had two guys get hung up and kind of thrown down in front of the bull's head that we had to go in and shoot the gap. And what I mean by shooting the gap is the space between the cowboy and the bull, and you run right through there, grab the bull, pick his head up, and make him look at me so that way he'll come with us and get the cowboy out of there. We had a pretty good hang up at the very end of the day with Ty Hamill, and he got beat up pretty bad, but there wasn't a whole lot more that we could do just because of the way where his rope ended up on the bull's belly, and it's really hard to get in there and try to get the cowboy out.
So what's the average weight of these bulls?
Average weight's anywhere between 1,400 pounds and 2,300 pounds is your average size bull, anywhere in that range. You get some bulls that are younger, they weigh a little bit less, and the older bulls weigh a little bit more.
So for me, who doesn't do this, might think you're a little bit insane when you say shooting the gap, lift the bull's head so he goes to you and not to the cowboy.
Yeah, we are a little bit insane, but you know, it's part of the game and we enjoy it, and we kind of take pride in being a little insane and losing our marbles.
If White Stew come charging into your rodeo arena, breakneck speed, and this lady can get the job done. She knows what it takes to be a superstar. Sue Blyle out and around the number two barrel, coming down to the far end for number three. Give her a big round of applause. Sue Blyle drives home. With a running time of 15.358. These ladies are smoking hot today. They had good days yesterday and even better days expected today. Lila McKenzie, the young lady all the way from Pickard around number two barrel, comes charging in. And hang on, cowgirl. She's one of the top contenders you'll see at any rodeo. And around the number three barrel, Lila charging home. Well, the running time today of a 16.072. Don't be afraid to hoot and holler. Kelsey Griffin out and around the number one barrel. Looking, doing a great job. The good bay horse digging in deep for number two. A good fast run coming. Kelsey Griffin, she got the job done. With the walking time, she even beat her own personal time of yesterday afternoon. She has a running time of 14.791. A 14.791. I mean, Kelly Brown, one of your hometown ladies, ladies and gentlemen, don't be afraid to let her know you came to watch a hometown hero in action. Odom around the barrel number one, the good black horse stretching out, making that left hand turn, and Melody Brown has got it under control down around the number three. Give it a big round of applause, your hometown cowgirl with a running time of 15.882. 15.882, the running time.
Yeah.
Of any of the rodeos you've done so far?
Actually, this year I got to fight my hometown rodeo in Newport, Washington. It's the biggest Pro West show there is, and I got to fight that this year. We ended up having 16 bull riders through the 2 days, and two of my good buddies rode. Ty Hamill won it, and it was a blast fighting the hometown rodeo and being in front of all my friends and family.
And so what does your family think about this job?
My family thinks I'm nuts, but they like it because I was never a really good bull rider. I was just kind of average. And with bullfighting, you can keep going, and you know, I study bulls every day of the week. I'm always sitting there watching videos of Cody Webster or Lloyd Ketchum or Dusty Tuckness. I'm always sitting there watching videos trying to learn how to get bigger and better. And they think I'm crazy, but they do enjoy the fact that how much fun I have at this.
So, I mean, this is a smaller circuit. What's your goal for bullfighting?
I eventually want to become a professional. Right now, I'm just kind of trying to move up through the ranks. This year, I worked for two associations, which are BCRA, and I also work for the Pro West. I'm also the Pro West Bull Riding Director this year. And you know, it's all a matter of having the contractors give you a call and say, hey, we want you to come to this rodeo, and you just keep moving up the ranks that way. It's all by word of mouth. There's no real self-promotion. You just kind of keep working with the contractors, working with the bulls, and that's how you move up through the ranks.
Well, stay safe out there. Have a great Sunday, and thanks for talking to us.
Thank you very much. We're definitely going to have some fun out there tonight.
We ask you to not clap at any time until the performance is over. She's been trick riding for 5 years across Alberta, and this is her third time performing at Valemount. Our next young lady is April. She's on her April Key on her horse, Diego. Diego is 8 years old. This is her third rodeo trick riding for Diego. And April new to the trick riding sport. And thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for inviting them to Valemount. All set for ready to go this afternoon. First maneuver you're going to see is Dana Powell in a backward bender. Next up we have Dana and the full fender. Next up, April in the side salute. Next up, we go with Dana in the suicide drag. One of the most dangerous maneuvers in trick riding. Next up, April in the forward fender. Now go down to Dana and the 1 foot. Now we go with April in the side saddle. Next up, we go with Dana in the shoulder stack. Next, we go with April in the backward fender. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're getting ready for Dana in the final act of her trick riding, doing the vault. round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give it up for the quick horses from West Rock and Alberta. And now, ladies and gentlemen, to go down to the stunt horse pack.
Everything ready. Tony's forgotten that it's not on work today. It's not on union time.
Tony, you're not getting paid by the hour, buddy. By the job. And here we go with the snow farmers. You got to go around your own barrel, young lady. Got our eyes focused on the barrel, out and around the barrel. Give them a big round of applause for the snow farmers. Tony, I don't know how to break it to you, but I don't think you're the champion. All our timers come forward with our time here on this afternoon. Pack horse racers, don't leave the arena. We're going to be getting everything all figured out for you guys. We get our time tabulated. Team Scotland had a running time with a 2:31 for Team Scotland. 3:08 the running time. And how did this work, timers? The fastest time overall? The aggregate. And I don't believe when you go with the aggregate, it is going to be the snow farmers with a total running time of 5:40. That is the overall aggregate time of 5:40, the total running time. Total running time for Team Scotland is 6:39. The overall, ladies and gentlemen, the winner is the snow farmers with a running time. Total running time of 5:40 over the 2 days. And at this time, timer, are you ready for what you told me? At this time, ladies and gentlemen, the fine folks that are part of the pack horse race this afternoon would like to make a special presentation this time. They have a buckle they would like to present to Mr. Tony Parigi. All the hard work and dedication you put into the sport. It's all greatly appreciated, Tony, all the hard work that you have organized. And we thank you very much, Tony, a nice shiny new buckle. You have a hold of pants up. Not no more of this sagging pants anymore, Tony. You can be looking proud. We thank you all for being here. Ladies and gentlemen, give our team a great big round of applause once again. A lot of hard work and entertainment goes into the sport of the pack horse race. Young man, make for the wait for the judges' tabulation. His older brother, score. An 82 point ride. An 82 by Cowboy, and that is the first man to make the qualified ride.
This is Virginia in front, and this is Valerie in the back, all the way from Valemount, British Columbia.
Oh,
give it up.
Wow, man. That is amazing.
Hey, what are these beauties? Look at these beauties. You want to see what we can do?
Oh, I'd love to see what you can do. How are you at good old ham rock and roll kind of smooth?
Let's do it. Anything goes today.
Anything goes? Are you ready?
Ready. Woo!
Up for the cowgirl around heading towards the number two barrel. Makes that left hand turn on two. Picks up the pace, adds a little bit of speed, and overdrive into the number three barrel. Give her a big round of applause for the young lady, Dana Foster, out of Clearwater. For the running time of 22.988, the running time. Canoe Mountain Rodeo. And down and around the number two barrel, down to number three. Isla Clayton makes the right hit and hand third and bring it hard home. Isla Clayton home. For the running time, 18.572. Darren Munson charging into that rodeo arena at breakneck speed, looking at barrel number one. Makes a nice turn on one across that rodeo arena, charging for the number two barrel. Out and around number two, you can't get any closer than that. Around two, down the far end for number three. Give a big round of applause. Here's Mr. Charging home. For the running time of 18.384, the running time for Darren Munson. Cowgirls up charging in that rodeo arena at breakneck speeds of up to 30 miles per hour. Danielle is out and around the number one barrel. Looking across that arena for barrel number two. And a nice turn on two down to the far end for number three. Give a big round of applause, Danielle Rogers. Came up from the junior ranks of high school rodeo, now competing in the senior division. 17 years of age, this young lady, as she heads down to the number three barrel. Katie Holland, charge home, Goggle, charge home. That good pass through your horse for barrel number one of that Cloverleaf Shake pattern. Now to cross that rodeo arena to reward you fine folks in the grandstand. Lisa Manuel knows how to run a set of barrels. This horse is fast, and she's down around number three. Give a big round of applause. Well, a running time of 16.349. So, ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the ladies' barrel racing, the game for day number two. She won it all yesterday, and again today, your hometown hero, Kelsey Griffin. She is the barrel racing champion in the ladies' barrel racing for two consecutive days in the ladies' barrel racing. And now we go down to our next cowgirl. This is Constance Schrouder out of McBride in the junior barrel racing, trying to beat the running time of a 16.076 by Gracie Antoine. That is the time I beat so far with a 16.076. This young lady, Constance Rauter, McBride, BC, cowgirl, had a good run happening so far around the number three barrel. Give her a rain. Constance headed home with a running time of a 22.810. A 22.810 is the running time for Constance Rauter. Adam Adler will get herself all set up with that good dark bay horse looking at barrel number one, a left-hand turn. She's starting out on the left-hand barrel. Across that rodeo arena, put barrel number two in the cloverleaf-shaped pattern. And a horse working well for the cowgirl. Get them all gathered up and headed down to the number three barrel towards the bucking chute. Takes that right-hand turn on three. Give her a big round of applause to her cowgirl here this weekend. Well, a running time of 22.733. Biford makes them go around the barrel number one to the far side for barrel number two for your hometown cowgirl. Holding around number two down to the far end. Alyssa, get him lined up. Line him up and make him go, cowgirl. Big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for Melissa Byford here this afternoon. Unfortunately, no time, broken pattern, and no time for the dollar up and a no cut. Yeah. After charging into the barrel, looking at the barrel pattern, charging into the number one barrel number, makes a right-hand turn on one. Across that rodeo arena is where the cowgirl got her eyes focused on the number two barrel. Nice turn on two. Down to the far end for number three, Astrid Ludwig. Get the job done, give her a big round of applause. Well, the running time, today is the tabulator time, the running time of 18.320 and 18.420, the running time. Gracie Antoine, come on in, Gracie, they have a buckle presentation for you. Buckle donated this weekend by D&B Rodeo Company. We thank you, D&B Rodeo, for your sponsorship. Give her all a great big round of applause. She is the number two junior barrel racing champion. Gonna be handing over all her paycheck over to Dad for traveling expenses. We appreciate good cowgirl attitude like that, Gracie. You hand your check over to Dad for traveling expenses down that rodeo trail. Grandpa gets a share too as well. And now, ladies and gentlemen, how many of you five folks are ready for round number two of bull riding? Now a question we have, how many of you folks are cheering for the bull rider? How many are cheering for the bulls? How many of you ladies are just here to check out the bull riders? Well, that's what we'd like to hear. Oh, get down to chute number three, Lane Gerson. Out of trouble over the top mark in Germany. For yesterday, last night, now he's back here. It's Valemount to be a champion this afternoon. Lane Gerson is the cowboy. A whole lot of heart and a whole lot of
drive
for that young man.
I won! Yeah, you know why I won? Because I came to Valemount today to rock and roll with the people! 1, 2, 3! Oh, you gotta do better than that, sweetheart!
1, 2, 3! They go with Justice Canyon on a bull they call Mach 3. How many of you folks were here last night for the bull riding? How many remember that wreck at the very end of our bull riding? Well, ladies and gentlemen, see that young man out in that rodeo arena hanging that bull, hanging on that rope for the chute gates? That is the cowboy that was in that wreck, and he's here today. That's Ty Hamill. Give him a big round of applause. Ladies and gentlemen, that cowboy's got a lot of heart and pride. He's pulling gates this afternoon. We appreciate Ty Hamill for being here. A big round of applause, and if that bull would have got a hold of him, he'd have had that highway to the hill as well, and no score. So far, only one qualified ride. That is the old-timer of the bull riding event. That is Tyrell DeRose, the oldest bull rider we have here this afternoon, the cowboy that came out of retirement from 6 years.
Ah, yeah! rock you.
Ladies and gentlemen, been a pleasure once again. God bless and have a great day.